Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Continental after it said strong growth in China for its auto unit will help offset sluggish demand in Europe. Shares of the German tire maker surged 9% on the news. Also in focus, shares of medical devices manufacturer Smith & Nephew after activist investor Sevian Capital disclosed a stake in the group. Smith & Nephew shares jumped 8%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Ericsson, which has recorded another $1 billion impairment charge for its acquisition of cloud communications firm Vonage in 2021. This sent shares of the telecom equipment firm lower by 1%.
Asian markets ended Thursday trade on a solid note on increased bets of a September rate cut. Japan's CK225 soared to a new all-time high, closing just below 41,000. Here at home, the local bourse extended its gains for a second day, pushing the main index above the 6,500 level.
We've been bullish in the last couple of days. We did a relatively strong rally from our lows of 6,158. No?
Yeah.
But I guess we can only go so much unless volume really picks up. I don't think this market can really turn into a real strong uptrend if we only trade like 4 billion a day.
Mm-hmm.
So we need more volume, we need more participants. Hopefully we need, you know, the foreign funds to come back and start buying again for this market to really trend up.
Some notable stock movements in the region. Samsung shares jumped 3.4% on expectations that tech giant will report a 13-fold increase in second quarter profit on Friday. That's as demand for AI technology fueled a rebound in memory chip prices. Also getting a boost from AI bets, SoftBank, which saw its share soar to a new historic high amid confidence over its AI prospects. Philippine neobank Zed secures a license from the Philippine Central Bank to operate as a standalone credit card issuer. The startup firm says it has received an overwhelming demand for its no-interest, no-fees titanium credit card with 40,000 people on its wait list. Zed also notes it is targeting to onboard young professionals.
Credit scores in and of themselves are flawed. The problem with them is that, you know, traditionally banks have relied on credit scores to decide on credit card applications. And it's broken because most people don't have credit scores when they're starting out, even if they have very solid jobs with very strong income potential. So what we're doing differently at Zed is we're taking in actual income data so that we can support this very promising and fast growing segment of our population that's been woefully underserved to date.
The European Union pushing ahead with its plans to impose tariffs on electric vehicles made in China. The EU says there's a 4-month window starting Friday during which the tariffs of up to 37.6% are only provisional. Intensive talks between the two sides are expected to happen during this time. The Commission justifies the tariffs by saying China benefits from unfair subsidization. It notes these post consequences on importers, users, and consumers of EVs in Europe. China has threatened to retaliate.